So today we are going to look at pulley systems, and we are going to start with the simplest possible Atwood machine that is composed of a pulley, fixed pulley to a fixed surface like the ceiling, and one piece of string or a chain going through that pulley with two objects hanging at the ends, at the two ends of that string. For all our pulley problems, we are going to consider our pulleys to be fixed and to be what we call ideal pulleys. Ideal pulleys are pulleys that have no mass and there is no friction. So all our pulleys for our problems will be considered ideal pulleys, massless and frictionless. We are going to start today by looking at the free body diagram of this pulley system with these two objects of masses M1 and M2. And let's consider that M2 is greater than M1. So if M2 is greater than M1, this entire system will have to move clockwise. So that's going to have to be our positive direction. We don't have a choice here anymore. We must go with the positive direction as given by our condition of M2 greater than M1. So we are going to show that over here with this big arrow, and that is going to be our positive direction for the forces when we are going to consider them. And let's go ahead and start considering the forces. We are going to start with M2. The forces acting on M2 will be the force of gravity, starting from the center of gravity, the force of gravity, always vertically downwards, there we go. Let's label it M2G. And there will be a force of tension in this string. Tension is always a pull along the string, always a pull along the string. So for tension, we are going to go along the string, upwards, a pull. There we go, in blue here. Label that T as in the force of tension. Now, those are the only two forces acting upon M2. Let's go ahead and move to M1 and see what forces act upon M1. Well, same things over here. M1g, the force of gravity, we have to make sure that this M1g is shorter than M2g because we already know that M2 is greater than M1. So our M1g, I'm going to make it shorter, only maybe this long. Label it M1g, and then there will also be a tension force acting upon M1. There is only one string in this entire pulley system, so therefore there will be only one tension. No matter where you measure it, the tension will have to be the same. So however long tension we had here, we're going to have here as well. And it's going to be, starting from the center of gravity, again a pull along the string, exactly the same length as this one over here. And let's label it T. So now we have M1G downward and T upward for M1, and M2G downward and T upward for M2. Let's go ahead and do a magnitude check. We know that the system will accelerate in this direction because of M2 being greater than M1. So therefore, the forces on both these objects must be unbalanced in such a way that for M2, M2G must be greater than T, and for M1, T must be greater than M1G. So let's go ahead and check those magnitudes and see if they are indeed what they are supposed to be. So once again, M2G must be greater than T because M2 accelerates downward. Well, M2G here is 8 centimeters, T is 5 centimeters, 8 is greater than 5, so magnitude check is okay on this object. Shows me an unbalance of forces in the favor of M2G. For M1, T must be greater than M1G because M1 accelerates this way. So let's go ahead and measure those again. We just measured t over here to be 5, so this should be also 5, and indeed it is 5 centimeters. And M1G here is only 4 centimeters. 5 is greater than 4, so therefore we do have what we wanted, an unbalance of forces in the favor of t in order for M1 to accelerate in that direction. So we just finished performing the free body diagram for this pulley system, for these two objects. Remember, the pulley is ideal, no mass, no friction. And we also did the magnitude check for both these objects, considering the given condition that M2 is greater than M1, therefore the whole system must accelerate clockwise. Thank you.